friends. Moses obeyed God and went to Egypt with his brother Aaron to free the Israelites from slavery. To prove to the Israelite leaders that they were speaking for God, Moses and Aaron showed them miracles like turning Moses' staff into a snake and then back into a staff. When the Israelite leaders saw the signs, they knew God had heard them. They bowed down and worshiped God. Say it with me. Remember who God is. Then Moses and Aaron went to Pharaoh and gave him God's message. Let my people go that they may worship me in the wilderness. But Pharaoh said, I do not know the Lord and I will not let Israel go. Pharaoh did not care about God. God's people were suffering because of Pharaoh's hard, sinful heart. Pharaoh said, and because of you, the Israelites aren't getting their work done. That same day, Pharaoh made the Israelites' lives even harder. As slaves, the Israelites made lots and lots of bricks to build things for Pharaoh. And as punishment, the Egyptian taskmasters beat them. When the Israelites went to Pharaoh to ask why he was doing this to them, he simply said, it's because you're lazy. You want to go and worship your God? If you have time to think about that, then you're not busy enough. Then Pharaoh doubled their work. Because of this, the people of Israel were angry with Moses and Aaron. They said, see what you've done? You've made our lives even more difficult now. This made Moses very sad. He cried out to God, why, Lord, why have you brought trouble on this people? Is this why you sent me? And God responded with three very important truths. One, God said, I am the Lord, God Almighty. It's for us to remember who God is. Two, God said, I am keeping my covenant, my promise, that I made to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Remember, God never forgets his promises. And three, I will deliver my people from the Egyptians. They will live in the land I promised to Abraham. This is for us to remember that God is the deliverer. When Moses and Aaron told the Israelites what God said, they still did not listen. All they could think about was how difficult slavery was. They forgot that God is bigger and stronger. He would deliver them. Moses and Aaron kept telling Pharaoh to let the Israelites go, but the Pharaoh refused. God was about to show that he is the one true powerful God over everything. Aaron took Moses' staff, stretched it over the Nile River, and the river turned to blood. The Nile was Egyptians' main source of water, and they worshipped it as a god. Now, for a week, the Nile was red with blood. Fish died. People couldn't drink the water or take baths. The land was stinky. And yet, people did not let God's people go. This was the first plague. And then, eight more plagues followed. Each plague was worse than the last, and each showed God's power over a god that the Egyptians worshipped. But still, Pharaoh would not let God's people go. God told Moses he was going to send one more plague to Egypt. After this one, Pharaoh would let the Israelites go. Even though Pharaoh's heart was hard, the people of Egypt were beginning to pay attention to God's power. Moses went to Pharaoh and told him God's message about the last and most terrible plague. At midnight, the firstborn, the oldest child of every family and of the animal that they owned, would die. But Israelite would not be harmed. Even with this warning, Pharaoh would not let the people go. God told Moses how the people of Israel would be saved. To show they trusted God to save them, each family was to take home a one-year-old lamb that was as perfect as possible. On the night when the firstborn would die, the family was to kill the lamb and put the blood on the sides and over the top of the door. The lambs would be a substitute or replacement, and dying in the place of the firstborn of the Israelites. This was God's plan to save his people from death and save them from suffering and slavery in Egypt. Once God passed over the houses, God also said that they were to cook the lamb and eat it as they were getting ready to leave Egypt. This meal was to be called the Passover. God wanted his people to celebrate this feast every year to remind them of how he saw their need and kept his promise to deliver them. The Israelites trusted and obeyed him. At midnight, where there was no blood on the doorpost, the firstborn of each family, both people and animal, died, just as God said. Families in every house all over Egypt started crying and wailing because of the sadness of death. This was the plague that caused Pharaoh's heart to be obedient to God's command. Pharaoh called Moses and Aaron and told them, "Go, take your families and your animals and your possessions and leave." God has shown his power to the Egyptian and to Pharaoh. When you are in hardship and difficult times, remember who God is. Pray to God and he will answer. He will deliver you from your troubles. Remember to trust him and obey him, and remember who God is.